The Parker Solar Probe is an historic mission, flying into the sun's corona for the first time, exploring the last and most important region of the solar system to be visited by a spacecraft. The sun is the only star we can study up close. By studying our star, we can learn more about stars throughout the universe. The sun is a source of light and heat for life on Earth. The more we know about it, the more we can understand how life on Earth developed. The sun is also the source of the solar wind, a flow of ionized gases from the sun that stream past Earth at speeds of more than 500 kilometers per second, a million miles per hour. Disturbances in the solar wind shake Earth's magnetic field and pump energy into the radiation belts. This is known as space weather. Space weather can change the orbits of satellites, shorten their lifetimes, or interfere with onboard electronics. The more we learn about what causes space weather and how to predict it, the more we can protect the satellites we depend on. Less than 60 minutes after launch, the spacecraft separates from the launch vehicle and begins the post-separation sequence. It will rotate itself to point at the sun. The solar arrays will open. The extraordinary heat of the sun will be the spacecraft's most intense challenge. At its closest approach to the sun, the front of the probe's solar shield faces thousands of degrees of heat. The spacecraft and instruments are protected from the sun's heat by the Thermal Protection System, TPS, a 4.5-inch thick, 8-foot-wide carbon composite graphic sheet affixed to carbon foam blocks. Because the carbon composite shield is such a poor conductor of heat, the spacecraft and scientific instruments behind it will stay about room temperature, protecting most of the spacecraft's components from the brunt of the heat encountered near the sun. The probe will maneuver itself to keep the heat shield facing the sun. Today's cutting-edge thermal engineering advances make it possible to offer this kind of protection from heat and radiation. The solar arrays will retract behind the protective shield as the spacecraft approaches the sun, and extend as the spacecraft retreats from the sun. The very outermost edges of the solar arrays are bent upward, and when the spacecraft is closest to the sun, small slivers of array will be extended beyond the protection of the heat shield in order to produce enough power for the spacecraft's systems. The incredible heat of our sun would damage conventional spacecraft arrays, so a first-of-its-kind actively cooled solar array system was developed. During approach to the sun, very small changes in the wing angle of the solar array can vastly change cooling requirements. Just 1 degree change in the array angle of one wing would require 35% more cooling capacity. The Parker Solar Probe carries 4 instrument suites designed to study and photograph the sun's structure, magnetic fields, plasma and energetic particles, and image the solar wind. The spacecraft systems and scientific instruments are located in the central portion of the shield's shadow, where direct radiation from the sun is fully blocked. NASA's historic Parker Solar Probe mission will revolutionize our understanding of the sun. The Parker Solar Probe will travel through the sun's atmosphere closer to the surface than any spacecraft ever before. It will face brutal heat and radiation, hundreds of times higher than here on Earth. The probe will orbit closer and closer to the Sun by using Venus's gravity, completing 7 flybys of Venus over 7 years to bring its orbit closer to the Sun each time. At its closest approach, the Parker Solar Probe hurtles around the Sun at 450,000 miles per hour, making it the fastest man-made object ever. The probe will zoom close to the Sun 24 times between 2018 and 2025, gathering a variety of data about the Sun's structure and magnetic and electrical fields. The probe will operate in the very hazardous region of the outermost part of the Sun's atmosphere, known as the corona, for the first time. The corona, made up of highly ionized elements like iron, helium, and calcium, is so hot that the Sun's gravity can't hold on to it. It will help scientists understand why the Sun's outer atmosphere is more than 200 times hotter than the Sun's surface. It will fly close enough to the Sun to watch the solar wind speed up from subsonic to supersonic. It will give scientists a better understanding of how and why this acceleration happens, so that we may be able to predict when it will happen. The probe will fly through the birthplace of the highest energy solar particles. It will spend a total of 30 hours within the corona before NASA turns off its transmitter and leaves it to its fate. And it will be a fiery one. The spacecraft will fly through the Sun's atmosphere as close as 3.7 million miles from our star's surface, which is well inside Mercury's orbit, and 7 times closer than any spacecraft that has come before. The Earth is 93 million miles from the Sun, so 3.7 million miles will be very close. In fact, the Parker Solar Probe will be more than 10 times closer to the Sun than Mercury. Because of our increasing dependence on technology and satellites, this study of our Sun will also help researchers predict and prepare for solar weather events. Without advanced warning, severe solar weather events could cause $2 trillion in damage in the U.S. alone, and the eastern seaboard of the U.S. could be without power for a year. The Parker Solar Probe will provide humanity with the closest ever observations of any star.